Good evening, ladies and gentlemen, this is Best in Slot, and tonight we're going to take a look at the next brand new DLC for Planet Zoo, the Aquatic Pack. 5 brand new animals, tons of new scenery items, and more importantly, aquatic moistness. They're going to be deep diving, as you can see here, on our penguins. I'm going to play the trailer for you right now. You can watch that whole thing. It's less than a minute long, but I've already prepared a series of slides like I'm a school teacher, and we're going to go through. I'm going to pick out what I think is the most important stuff. So enjoy the trailer. Join me in a second. So before we dive too deep in, let's take a look at a summary of what the pack is all about. So the Aquatic Pack, out on the 8th of December, that's 1 week from today. Let me check my phone. That's 1 week from today. It's going to contain 5 different animals. That is the king penguin, which we're going to see throughout this, the giant otter, the grey seal, which we are also going to see very slightly, the dwarf caiman, and the diamondback terrapin. It's following the usual sort of system, wherein the diamondback terrapin is of course a terrarium animal rather than a full-fledged one. 170 new scenario items, scenery items, and a new time scenario as well. Very, very cool. There is also going to be a bunch of new free stuff. We'll talk about that at the end. I only just saw that today, but update 1.4, I believe it is, that's going to come along with this. It's going to bring a lot of stuff for you who aren't going to buy the pack. But before that, let's talk about the pack. So I've pulled out some screenshots from both the Steam page and from the trailer itself. So the interesting thing about this pack, beyond it just being an aquatic pack, which is kind of a big deal, is that the scenery comes from all over the world. Of course, aquatic doesn't mean anything in particular, except, you know, moist. So they've pulled from many different areas. We're going to have sort of warm, rainforesty kind of environments, we're going to have frigid polar caps, and we're going to have what looks to me like a very typical, in terms of the architecture, like a very American marine park kind of thing. It's got like a little bit of a Maine vibe to it. I don't really know America, but that's the vibe I keep getting. But you can see little things like the tower over here, which seems to be like a feeding pen or something. It's definitely, or maybe it's just an attraction, but it's like a lifeguard tower, very Baywatch over there. And what I mean mainly is this over here on the right hand side. They've used the wood we already have in the game, I believe. And then they've got this new blue texture we're going to see a lot of, but also these new blue aquatic paths as well. It's the kind of stuff you'd seen, like, you know, sea life parks, basically, over in the US and, hell, over here in the UK as well. Not too much to say about this one. This is an interesting item. We'll talk about that in a second. This is, of course, our penguin exhibit over here on the right-hand side. There are babies in there, and again, we'll get a close look at those in a moment. But this is a nice overview, more than anything else, of what your aquatic park might look like, and you can see already how it is a little bit of a hodgepodge of different things coming together, and I'm really excited about that, because usually you add a new region via a park and that's really exciting, but you're also very limited in terms of your scope because they're all suited to this region. Now we can expand many different zoos, you know, it's gonna be cool. As promised, baby penguins. This one over here is my happiest penguin ever. You can't really make it out, but he's looking straight up at his parents, or she's looking straight up at their parents, just kind of like, "Mom, Dad, I'm hungry, hook me up." They're using the sprinkles over here. The penguin looks beautiful. The animals always look beautiful, so there's not much point talking about that, but they really, really do. I think this is a new rock type. I'm not 100% sure, but it seems to have kind of like this frigid polar look to it that we don't usually have. Likewise, over here we have what looks like slates of ice, making this sort of staircase. I believe they're new as well. You get another look at the sort of Coast Guard tower in the distance. It seems to have a light in it, or something, or a fan, or Don't quite know what this is yet. Still gonna have to work on that one as we go through. We also have like a really nice mural over on the right hand side. Of course, we're gonna have tons of new art pieces as well. Some for the penguins, some for the more polar ice cap kind of theme, and some again for that warmer theme we're gonna see with, say, the caiman. And there's a little glimpse at that warmer theme. We'll talk about this. Not allowed to look at that yet. We'll talk about this in a moment, but this is one of the new things we're getting. This again could be a new rock type. I again don't recognize it straight up. It's a really nice looking rock. Again, it looks fairly tropical. We'll see about that. But this here is a new feature called the Cascading Waterfall feature. Now, you can already make cascading waterfalls in this game. You kind of just have to keep angling your waterfall tools in certain ways. But this seems like it's going to make that a lot easier. I don't know how that's going to work. I really don't, but if it can make cascading waterfalls that look better and nicer and are easier to do, then that's obviously a really cool thing. One thing I would really like as well is the ability to make waterfalls go for longer. I tried to do some fairly excessive waterfall builds and they always fall pretty short and, you know, the water would just keep going, so it would be nice if we could extend that range. We do have some new plantage on this screen as well. These boys over here are brand new as well. These are, I want to say cypress, but people will shout at me if I'm wrong. I'm not great with plants, I'll be honest. And I believe... No, that's not new. So, that's new. Moving on. Likewise, this beautiful new tropical plant we have. I recognized it instantly, and I've got no idea what it's called. I googled plant with huge stick. A plant with huge... I mean, I assume that's just an excessive stamen, I have no idea, but I couldn't find out. Please feel free to let me know in the comment section what this flowering plant is, but it's very pretty, and then again, it's nice that we're getting things from around the world. We're not limited to one region. Now, as we've said, there is a new time scenario coming along with this, and this seems to be part of it, so we're going to have at least 12 different habitat species, at least 2,300 guests, 3 animals with a 5-star rating, yearly profit of 65k, and a overall zoo rating of 4 out of 5. So this is a pretty good zoo, but it also gives us a glimpse, more importantly, at some of the mechanics of the, what is a fairly dull penguin habitat. But over here we can see this is the underwater viewing area for the penguins, which I suspect will be made a little bit easier to do. Maybe we'll have a specific underwater viewing area path or bridge or tool or something to make underwater viewing a little bit easier. It's not difficult to do right now, but... And then we have these, I think these are meant to be, what would you call them? It's kind of like a supporting structure that hangs on there, because obviously there's water down here. That wall is taking a lot of pressure because it can't just be solid. It's hollow in there because people are going to walk through there. If it was, you know, solid, that would be, they would have to be ghosts, basically. They could also be lights, frankly, because they look like lights. Fire at a sea box. Reference. Okay, let's move on there. Hopefully no fires at your sea parks. Not much to say on this one, just pretty. Just wanted to show it off. That's about it, really. It does look brilliant. The penguin, it looks so curious. This one on the right hand side, it's like he spotted the camera. He's like, what's going on? I knew. What's going on? Timmy, what's going on over there? George, you know what? I don't have a bloody clue. That was my impression of two penguins called Timmy and George. I'm here all week. So, yeah, new rocks, seemingly, I think, they've been staggered together to create this flooring. It actually looks really nice, and it's the kind of thing you would expect to see in a penguin habitat. Not much new in there, but it's cute. There we go, a little closer look at what else. And again, this, to me, has that main kind of vibe. Am I crazy? It's definitely got an American kind of feel to it, either way. This, I still don't know. Is this a power station? Is it a lamp post? I cannot figure out what this is. Initially, I thought it was attached to this. This is a shop, so we've got a new, you know, shop covering over here on the right-hand side. Actually, this looks very British. I'm going to take part of that back. But I have no idea what this is. There's something mechanical on the inside, which to me looks like a light. We'll have to wait and see. I'm very curious. What do you guys think this is? It's got a little cat on the top and a mouse. That's adorable. And over here on the left, we have a good look at some of the new sculptures, a new sort of construction items. We've got a couple of seals there jumping around. We've got a little seal over here. Not really getting involved, poor lad. And you can see this one up here. There's a bird there. It's like a little gull. We'll see that in closer detail in a little bit. But what I'm really excited about, which may be sad, is this down here, the rocks. I don't know if this has always been possible in Planet Zoo's rocks. That to me looks very different, because Planet Zoo doesn't have that many small rocks. The rocks tend to be fairly big, but that's like a really nice varied collection of small rocks, and it makes this really interesting ground texture. Now, it could just be part of this display. As you can see, there's another seal right there. But if we could make something like that, or have, or it, use it at least, you know, like the mulch in the game where you put down like a square of it underneath your existing items, if we could do that with like a rock plate or something, that would be really, really cool, because I really like the look of that. So hopefully that's something we get to see in game. Back to the tropics for our Diamondback Terrapin. Now, we don't really get to see him, but he's in here somewhere. I believe this is four of them put together. These are the new exhibits, and we have new aquatic. Well, it's not terrarium anymore, is it? Well, for a terrapin, it could still be a terrarium. Terrarium slash aquarium. But there's lots and lots of water in there. I think that's really cool. Hopefully, I don't know. I feel like we need a bigger animal pack and something to, like, expand this out. Because only one aquatic animal is a little bit silly. But we also don't want a normal content pack to be taken up by the terrarium animals, you know? So we need, like, a mix and match, I think. Either way, it looks really cool. Really excited to see how these function, these new water ones, what we can do in terms of editing the foliage inside and stuff like that. This is nobody's favourite feature, or at least I assume it isn't, but it's nice to get a new type, and it's going to mix things up a little bit, and I'm excited to see that. I don't have that much else to say on the matter, quite frankly. Moving on to our penguin. So all these shots now are ones that I pulled specifically from the trailer rather than the screenshots you've seen so far, which were on Steam. So there is a penguin. Now the penguin has, I just want to showcase this, basically. This is a piece of wood you put down. It's kind of like the bubble on JPOG, but not really. And the penguin swoops under here and pops out of the hole and stands on the ramp and, you know, shows off your guests, basically. It's a way for the penguins to be closer to the guests, because you can put them in the middle of the water while still being able to hang around on land. I think that's the main idea. That's a pretty good idea. Another nice overview of the park. Again, you can see this blending of sort of typical sea life park down to a more tropical sort of area. I like the idea of having this as kind of like an oasis amongst a more rugged tropical kind of thing. That's also our second new path type over there. It's hard to get a... Is that a new path or is that the gravel one? I can't tell. I've only seen one new path so far, so I'm kind of like on the lookout for the other new path, because we know there's a second coming. It looks like they've done some pretty cool stuff over here. I don't know if this is new or done with existing tools, but the roof has been covered in foliage in a pretty interesting way. We'll have to see how realistic that is. I believe this tree over here is new as well, as is this pole thing, which I'm assuming is the aquatic lamppost based on the style, although it has the same style as the building over here. There's a lot of this sort of ridged white material being used. I don't know things. Another shot there of the tropics looking lovely. Don't think there's anything much new there in the slightest. Although this is, again, looks potentially new. That's a new sort of tropical kind of covering. And this weirdo tree over here as well. And there is a closer look at the beloved gull, which seems to pop up constantly in this pack. Honestly, every building on one corner has a little gull, like they're watching, because birds aren't real. And it's just a little wooden gull, and it's adorable. Now, I said we were going to get a closer look at the seals, and by seals, I actually meant otters, because I'm an idiot. So, this is the look at the otter exhibit. Of course, we've got two brand new sort of scenery items, but the more important thing, if we click this button over here, ba-da-ba-dum. The important thing here is we seem to have brand new lily pads, unless I'm mistaken. Anyways, we also have new otters, of course. The giant otter, going to be adorable. All I hope for in this pack is that the otters make the exact noise they make in real life, because then I will spend all my time with the baby otters, because baby otters squeaking gets really annoying after about 5 minutes, but it's incredibly adorable until then. I'm just really excited to be able to like walk underneath there and, you know, walk by and see them diving down. It's going to be very, very cool. This is a pack that, more than any of the others, kind of fundamentally changes the game. It's not a huge thing, you know, we're not doing seemingly like marine life shows and stuff like that, which probably wouldn't make sense to include because we're not going to have cetaceans. I still don't think they're ever going to make the cut for various, you know, moral, political reasons, blah, 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 blah. But it's still very cool. Look at some plants. There you go. we got another sort of overview. It isn't a new path, that's the path we already have. Another look at the cascading waterfalls. And whatever the hell this is. I really don't know. Oh, I like that they're walking under the plant here, though. That's pretty cool. What is this? Is it a light? I mean, they look like lights. It could also be a speaker. It might be a speaker. We also have these much more mangrovey looking plants in the background. I think they may be new. There's so many foliage options in Planet Zoo now that I don't quite remember them all off the top of my head. I know this is new. I tend to be able to pick out the new stuff. I know that's new and that's new though. So that's at least two new foliage options right there. Little look there, we get a new look at the terrapin over there. There it is, looking adorable. We don't see the terrapin in any of the images, but between that and also that closer up image of the seal, we get a little glimpse of what it might well look like. Likewise, this terrifying dog over here. Oh, it's the caiman. I had to zoom in and check. That's the caiman right there. It looks terrifying on that image. Jesus Christ. Or I assume it's the caiman anyway. Horrifying. Right. And our final image before we talk about some of the new free stuff is this one here. And again, just showing off the path, which is really nice. Looks like it's, you know, rippling water. And we have this new display item over here. And the gull. I wonder if they've done this on purpose. The gull is there. It's also over there. The gull is absolutely bloody everywhere. We had this kind of ragged, what's that, heart-ish, or squished peach. This sort of spiky, modern art-ish penguin display thing. It's cool. It's cool. It's all, everything looks great. I don't feel like I've seen like a billion new scenery items, which you usually would, but it is a much shorter trailer than usual. The pack is out in 7 days, so we're going to see all of this in just a week's time. That's really, really exciting. But along with that, if you don't want to spend your hard-earned moolah on the Aquatic Pack, you can instead have a look at update 1.4. Now, this was posted yesterday, and I somehow, or 2 days ago, and I somehow completely missed it, because it basically told us the pack was going to be the Aquatic Pack before the Aquatic Pack got announced. So this was the header image, and this is our one of our crocodilios diving down to a new underwater feeder, and this is not the caiman. But what is important about this is that it shows that this new deep diving feature that the animals are going to have, the ability to properly dive under the water instead of just floating around on the top as they usually do, is going to apply retroactively. It's not just going to apply to the new DLC animals, but it's going to apply to older ones as well. This is our current crocodile diving down to the new feeder, which we'll talk about in a second. So that is really, really cool. So we'll have to go back and see which animals are capable of doing this. Will the hippos finally sink to the bottom? We'll have to wait and see. Now, let's talk about what's actually going to be in this update. With update 1.4, we'll be adding a new water temperature regulator facility. It allows you to customize the temperature of all water volumes. So no longer do you just have to control the temperature above ground, but now in the water as well. And that is about all there is to say on that. So we're going to have new heat map modes and new stuff to control all of that as well. And obviously different animals are going to require different temperatures in their water. This might make exhibit control for existing animals, again, more complex. I don't know whether all animals are going to need this, but maybe all animals with deep water that they can swim in are going to require some form of temperature regulation. That's going to add yet another thing we have to do to all our exhibits. We also have an underwater feeder, which you've just seen here, the underwater box feeder, a new feeding station, will be part of the free update. The only animal that uses in the game is the saltwater crocodile. Never mind. We'll be adding this to more animals in the future. When using this feeder, like any other food enrichment, its information panel, blah, 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 blah. So the salty over here is at the moment the only animal that will use it, but it's, you know, as they say, they're going to bring in new animals down the line. I imagine it's, maybe they're not just deep diving randomly, but maybe it's a custom animation to go and feed from it. So they need to kind of design that for the other creatures. That might well be it. Either way, we'll keep an eye out on what else gets in the future. We're also going to get zoo management for transport rides. I'm not going to go through all of this, but just better ways of managing your transport rides, which is good because at the moment they feel often a little bit pointless to me. We have a new challenge scenario, so not the one tied to the DLC. This one takes us to the Philippines, set in the mountains of Luzon. Take on an adventure and transform disused rice terraces while pushing conservation awareness. Make sure you have it ready in time for the grand opening ceremony. It's very cool. I actually have never done a timed scenario in this game. They got added a few patches back, so might be something we take a look at. And finally, added creativity. We can't wait to see what you do with the new free scenery assets. Update 1.4 will bring you a set of decal decorations, two new guest paths, one new queue path, and two variants to pre-existing queue paths, a new font for your New font for your 3D letters. That is such a big deal. Oh my god, hopefully they've reordered it. 2D letters, that's really cool as well. And a range of foliage. That is the most exciting thing right there. Because the font we have at the moment is cool, but it's also, it's very, I guess I shouldn't get too excited until we see what it is. But the font we have at the moment is very lackadaisical. It's a chilled out font. And what I really want to see is something a little bit more professional looking, a little bit more modern, because that's the one we're lacking right now. That's very, very exciting. Anyway, so that is all going to be free, everything I just talked about. Don't have to buy the pack. I assume this will drop on the 8th of December along with the Aquatic Pack. That's about it, folks. Very, very exciting. Let me know what part of this you're most excited for down below. If we get a glimpse at any of those three animals in the next 7 days, I'll probably bring you that in a video. Four animals, I should say. And yeah, let me know what you're excited about. Did you spot anything I missed? Let me know that in the comment section down below as well. That is about it. I will see you lovely folks in the next video. Cheers, my love, as always. Bye-bye.